I don't know why, but I'm kind of shipping the two of them. I'm talking about the redhead and the cutie secretary. I mean, but then again, I also don't want to hand over our cutie secretary over to that asshole. Oh, the woos of life. I am getting nervous about Mr. Yoon though. I'm getting nervous that the redhead may do something to get to him, to get to Suha. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my social media at @sealedforjoshi, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more yaoi content. If that's something that interests you, feel free to follow me at @sealedforjoshi. Finally, this episode will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into chapter 77 and 78 of My Suha. The title is My Suha in the first place. See how that just screams possessiveness? The title gave it away, guys. If this is a vanilla story, then the title would suggest more about the two of them, not a one-sided comment like My Suha or something objectifying, you know? I love the Sang-woo vibes though. Anyway, I kind of see a hint of kindness from Ji-won this week, and that's a big hope, but he still respects Suha at some sort though, even though with all of the craziness that's going on right now. As for the freaking redhead there, you freaking bitch, I'm a freaking kill you if you go near Suha or Ji-won right now. Please someone stop this crazy Ji-won from being so anxious to the point where something he's becoming obsessed or something to Suha. It's just because of the redhead people. He's the root of all of our problems. Let's just get rid of him. Who wants to join me? The redhead dude doesn't care about sharing Suha with others. Then Ji-won is becoming very possessive, and there is no in between the two of them. No relationship is perfect. Not everything's going to be all fluffy. They probably aren't compatible now that he is getting a little bit possessive. Come on, reasons why people break up anyway. Ji-won needs someone to understand him and makes him feel secure. Help him get some therapy, but will choose to stay despite all of that. And that is going to be Suha, people. I know it's gonna be a roller coaster, but we all know it's in the title. It's gonna be Suha. But when I thought this was already weird enough, because his character is somewhat back to how he was in the early chapters, Ji-won is getting even worse sometimes. And what makes it worse is Suha isn't as vocal as he used to at the start of this series. I don't know what to think about this series because I kind of see both sides of Ji-won's mentality. But what I cannot like fathom is Ji-won can afford a new house but not a therapist. All that money and you cannot get yourself a decent therapist. On the other hand, this is getting really toxic. I hope they start working on some relationship repair soon. But then again, a part of me knows even though it looks really bad, I really don't think that Ji-won is holding Suha hostage. I know it doesn't make sense, but a part of me also can't let go of the fact that how can you not be worried for your partner that almost got raped and you yourself almost got raped? And the rapist is still out there with enough power to do whatever he did before and get away with it like he did before. They were lucky nothing happened, or almost nothing happened the first time. But maybe they won't be as lucky the next time. And the redhead doesn't seem to be giving up at all. I would be scared as hell to go out too. G1 seems to be a bit scary, I get it. But his trauma, I do understand. And I don't know why Suha has no reaction or fear or whatsoever. I don't know if this is some sort of fetish or whatever he's going through, but he really should be careful. And as for G1, I know a lot of you guys has a lot of concerns over G1. I don't really think he's as toxic as a lot of people think he is. He's worried, he's anxious, that's it. He's traumatized of what happened. How can you not think that he's anxious because the redhead might pull something more disgusting, right? Not only to Suha, but also to G1. How can you not think that G1 is not scared? Because he's traumatized when Suha left him with the redhead before. Like, it might happen again, you know? Do you all don't know the feeling of seeing the person you've loved for years and you saw him left you with a guy that you hate when you are dating? I mean, get a grip. We are all reading the same manhwa, or you just can't seem to understand what's happening, or just say whatever gibberish you want. Or maybe I'm saying some gibberish that I want. But I also get what you guys are trying to say. Even though his past explains his behavior right now, I do get it, okay? Some of his behavior does not excuse his current behavior. And I get it. It kind of feels like one step forward and three steps backwards. I mean, I'm just focusing on the fact that G1 still thinks that Suha is the love of his life, and he just wants to protect him for now. I know it's complicated. We just have to sit back and see it through the end, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me. I'd love to hear back from you. And please consider supporting the show by donating as little as 99 cents through www.sealedfujoshi.xyz. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manhwa details can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.